Good evening and welcome to the Oak Park Activities Complex at Oak Park High School. Tonight's Ivy High School Game of the Week, Suburban Red Conference Football as Fort Osage on the road at Oak Park for senior night for the Northmen. Hi, everybody. Kevin White, Danon Hughes back from the Chiefs to help us out, and Les Norman from Breaking the Norm as well. We're on Spectrum News for the Hy-Vee High School Game of the Week, and a lot on the line tonight. The conference crown on the line tonight, and we got two red-hot teams.
Yeah, two red-hot teams. You look at Fort Osage. They started off slow earlier in the season, lost three of their first four games, but have been absolutely hot since then. And then Oak Park, undefeated on the season. A lot on the line tonight. It's going to be a fun matchup.
Time now for the Hy-Vee player profile. Running backs in the spotlight, and we'll start with River Peppers of Fort Osage.
Well, we got a little throwback game here because we're talking about the run game being prominent for each team. River has done an outstanding job this year, averaging 175 yards a game, and he's done a phenomenal job leading this team.
And for the Northmen, they've got Trayvon Pankey.
Yeah, Pankey, a speedster, a guy that can dominate in the run game as well. It's going to be fun. It might be the fastest game of the season in high school football here in Missouri. They're going to do an outstanding job up front in the trenches is where the war is going to happen, but they got those weapons in the backfield like him.
Fort Osage at Oak Park for a conference crown in 2023. It's the Hy-Vee High School Game of the Week, and we're back with the opening kickoff right after this. Hy-Vee proud to support Kansas City High School Athletics. Beautiful fall night here in the Northland. It's 70 degrees. And we are ready for the opening kickoff.
Oak Park won the coin toss,
deferred their option to the second half. The head coach of the Indians is Brock Bolt in his eighth year, four conference titles, including last year and four district titles. His team state runners up in 2022 to Francis Howell. Also was the head coach of the Greater Kansas City Football Coaches Association All-Star Game. He led Missouri to a victory. Ken Clemens, seventh year, and his fourth head coaching job was the Winnetonka head coach, Raytown and Liberty North. But he's back where he graduated in 1986. That is Ken Clemens. He was a star player and went on to play at William Jewell. And let's go down to the sidelines. Here's Les Norman.
Thanks, guys. This is an epic matchup tonight. You've got Fort Osage coach Brock Bolt, who said, we don't have a game plan. We're going to do what we do. And I talked with linebacker Anthony Thompson. He said the same thing. They run a lot of the option. We're just going to do our thing. On the Oak Park side, they have to stop the big run, talking with coach Ken Clemens. So it's going to be River Peppers for Fort Osage versus the Wall, Cam Wall of Oak Park. And then it's going to be Trayvon Pankey versus Anthony Thompson on the linebacking side for Fort Osage. An epic matchup, two epic running games. We'll see who breaks the big run.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
As you take a look at the deep man, guess who? River Peppers. When you got a star like this, you use him all over the place. Kicking off will be Xander Culp for Oak Park, and they do not kick it to Peppers. No shocker there. It's fielded on a couple of hops inside the 25. Short return out near the 30-yard line for the Indians, coming in at 5-3. But, Danon, you mentioned in the open, they've won four straight after a slow start to their season, so they're a red-hot team.
Yeah, well, we got a chance to speak with Coach Brock Bolt. He talked about the emergence and the growth process of his entire team. So he said coming into this game, he's got great leadership with Gallman, Peppers, and Thompson at that middle linebacker position. He said the keys to winning this game is going to be winning and blocking and tackling, containing the quarterback and running back for Oak Park, and limit their mistakes. But as Les mentioned and we talked about in the open, it's going to come down to the run game, who wins in the trenches.
Here's Peppers, his first toe of the night, short gain. Peppers averaging 9 yards per carry, 175 yards per game.
That was a great job of penetration up front by the defensive line for Oak Park. Got some big bodies up there with Jordan Bruce, Ben Brandis, Tate Ruth, Dom Cude. Good solid, beefy front for Oak Park.
Second down and long. Kyle Wilson, his first pass, looking for Penniman down the field, the over-the-shoulder catch. And it is a catch. It signaled a catch as the officials get together and they'll spot it near the 35-yard line. What a catch just locating this ball was tough.
Yeah, he did an outstanding job. You can see flipping his shoulders, his eyes around, still keeping the focus on the ball, knowing exactly where he was on the field. High school football, you only need 1 foot in bound. Outstanding catch by the sophomore, Penniman.
That is 36 yards and a first down for the Indians as they're on the plus side. And a flag flies before the snap. Referee tonight is Brian Keith.
False start, offense, number 9. 5-yard penalty, first down.
That's on Snodgrass, the wide receiver. Coach Bolt says we run a spread offense, but we'll run it 75% of the time. Simon Tatagi is their offensive coordinator. They're averaging 42 points per game, 394 yards per game, 304 of which come via the ground. So they are a running football team. And now they're behind the sticks, first and 15. This is a backward lateral to Peppers. And not much gain there as he threw the ball behind him there as Peppers gets his 11th catch of the year.
And this is mainly a perimeter run, just an opportunity to spread the field, try to get the speed of Peppers on the edge. Outstanding job by the Oak Park D-line just to be able to track him down, knock him back for only a couple yard gain.
Now it's second down and a dozen. And this is Peppers, and he is gang tackled at the 38 yard line.
River Peppers, the ball carrier.
Good job there. Jordan Bruce leading the way. Also, a Cam Wall, the Mike linebacker and leading tackler for the Northmen.
Well, there's a party of Northmen in the backfield. You see multiple blue helmets.
That brings up
four, five guys in on that play. Excellent job shedding the blocks. You mentioned Jordan Bruce. Brandis is in there as well. Shed those blocks. Make a living in the backfield of Fort Osage.
Now the penalty got him behind the sticks. Now third down and 14. Wilson stepping up and throwing to the sideline. Has his man. That is Penniman. And he is fast. His brother played here not too long ago. And I'll tell you, Nicholas Penniman is their most targeted receiver, and he's had the two biggest plays on this first drive, Dana. That's a first down catch.
Well, this is a lapse on the defense. You can see the focus came in right there. You see at the top of the screen the option for the defender to go to the quarterback and relinquish his duties on the sideline. That's outstanding job by the quarterback finding Penniman.
Yep, and this is Peppers right up the heart of the defense into the end zone. Touchdown, Fort Osage on their first drive of the game as it's a 16-yard rushing touchdown for River Peppers, his 26th rushing touchdown of the year, 27th overall if you include his rushing stats. So big play catches by Penniman of 36 and 22, and then it's capped by guess who? River Peppers is Xander Shepherd in for the PAT. He's only missed one on the year. 43 of 44, first team all-conference kicker. And this one through the left side, up and good, and a good start for the visitors on the road, Dana.
Yeah, they love the spread and power run. As you mentioned, over 75% run for Fort Osage. And when you can able, you have the ability to break tackles like that, just need a little bit of a crease, and a guy like Peppers will make a defense pay.
And the key drive guy, I really thought was Penniman, that over the shoulder 36-yard catch, and then the 22-yard catch on a third down and long kept the drive alive after you thought it was going to be sabotaged by the penalty.
Well, we thought, and we talked about the keys from Coach Bold. He talked about limiting the mistakes, and you hate to have a big play and then have an immediate negative play, but they were able to reel themselves back in, Kevin, get big plays again, and get the first score on the board.
This is the team that was the state runners-up in Class 5. They lost to Francis Howell in the championship game, 49-21. It's a team that beat Oak Park twice last year, but both games were in Independence at Fort Osage Stadium, 35-30. And 44-25 in the state playoffs. So they were close games, but solid wins for Fort Osage. And once again, the conference crown on the line tonight. And Fort Osage, the defending champs, don't want to give it away as they will kick off. Shepard has it on the tee. Sends it down the field, and this one will get in the end zone for a touchback. So no return. And now we get our first look at Aiden Hinkle and the Northman offense. Hinkle, all-time hits leader in baseball, and a star quarterback and good runner of the football, 7.1 yards per carry. And there's his passing numbers. He completes 45% of his passes, but the ratio here, Danen, on this offense, 80% they'll run the ball, 20% pass, so it's even higher. More of a running team, and Pankey's their main guy.
Well, Coach talks so highly about Hinkle and what he brings to the table for this team from a leadership perspective.
And they'll run it across the 30-yard line. And right on cue, their quarterback, who, like I said, 7.1 yards per carry. He can run the football as a QB.
Yeah, and you can see the extra effort by the offensive lineman getting out in space. That's what you want to see from your guys up front. That kind of attitude, that kind of effort permeates the entire team, the entire lineup. That's why you're able to get big plays like Hinkle.
Going to Missouri Southern to play college baseball. High GPA kid, 3.7 GPA, and probably might be their MVP of this team. First down run, his first pass of the game down the field, and it's a catch. The coach's son, Drew Clemens, rips it out of the air across midfield for a first down catch.
Tall, rangy tight end, high pointing the ball. This is what they say, got mossed, good coverage downfield, but even a better effort by Clemens. Stops, high points the ball, secures it with strong hands. I always talk about God gave you 10 good reasons to catch the ball. It's called fingers. It's an outstanding job by Clemens.
Yeah, it's his eighth catch of the year. His brother was a quarterback here. Drew is a tight end. Here's Pankey showing some patience, but he runs to the short side of the field. Not much room there. And he'll get a gain about 3 or 4 on his first carry of the game. But we've seen some great catches by Penniman and Clemens early on in what's supposed to be a running back's delight tonight.
Well, I think that each team is trying to loosen up the defenses by showing that they'll pass early. They know that their bread and butter is the run game. But that last play was made by Anthony Thompson, that linebacker we spoke about, the junior linebacker. Big-time playmaker, sideline to sideline player.
Hinkle, another great decision, spinning, still fighting, and close to the first down. As he's going to have about 7, and it's enough for a first down. Another nice, patient run by the quarterback, Aiden Hinkle, for Oak Park.
A good action in the backfield. You're seeing the misdirection and how it's affecting the defense. Then just tough, hard-nosed running by Hinkle. Not going to go down easy. As you see his numbers there, 57 rushes for over 400 yards and 7 touchdowns as the quarterback.
And he gets 7 yards per carry, and that's the big number. As now Braxton coming in the game. He's a big play guy in the backfield along with Pankey. Those three guys in the backfield, I got a scouting report. Those are the three guys. 1, 2, and 7. Watch out. As here's the quarterback going to take off and run. And Hinkle finds a gap. Hinkle inside the 20. And he'll be inside the 15-yard line. Move the chains again. Hinkle been the star of this first drive of the game, running the football.
But normally you'd like to see the ball carrier stop and have to restart. Defenses love to see that. But when you have the speed of Hinkle, he's able to set up his blocks, hit the sideline, and another huge gain for the Northmen.
24 yards and a first down for Aiden Hinkle. Once again, the all-time hits leader at a school that's been very successful playing high school baseball, Oak Park High School. And he's going to go to Missouri Southern College Baseball. And again, here's Hinkle using the spin move a lot here early on as he somersaults down for a nice gain on that first down run.
Yeah, we got to give some love to those big guys up front. You know, my guy Rich Baldinger would love for me to talk about the offensive line, but when you get those kind of efforts, you see Mahdi out in front, Williams as well, Logan Westling, Garcia and Kearns. Big body offensive linemen, great mobility shown. And when you can just give a crease to a guy like Hinkle, that's why these guys are so successful. undefeated on the season because of those big guys up front.
The All-Stater at left guard is Williams. Second down. And Hinkle continues to call his number. And he'll get down near the one-yard line. The quarterback. Ten touchdown passes, two INTs, but running the football is his strong suit.
Yeah, making good decisions on when to hand the ball off. That's a nice touchdown-saving tackle by Grayson Moore, the junior weak side linebacker for Fort Osage.
First and goal after that run, spotted at the one. Looking for the equalizer are the Northmen. And here's Pankey right up the middle, and he makes it look easy into the end zone. Touchdown for the junior Pankey, his 23rd rushing touchdown of the year.
And this is all the offensive line getting the job done. That left side, we talked about Jalen Williams and Westling at the left tackle. Run the ball right up the gut.
Number 17,
great counter punch by the Northmen to score the touchdown after Fort Osage initial drive.
And the extra point is up and good. It's Mario with the PAT, but this is pretty easy with the blocking. That was a big blue push right there.
Yeah, a lot of helmet on helmet. We've seen the blue helmets swallowing up Fort Osage front seven. Easy touchdown run for Trayvon.
The big star of the drive, though, was the quarterback running the football. Aiden Hinkle had some big-time runs. Both teams very effective on their first drive. Should we call a shootout here, Nathan? a running game shootout.
I think so, but hey, don't sleep on the passing game as well. We've seen some big time passes, but we know that each of these teams is gonna lean on the run game. And as I talked to the coaches during the week, we talked to Oak Park and Coach Clemens, he said, gotta eliminate the big plays. They had a couple on that first drive by Fort Osage. And then it's about the blocking and tackling for Fort Osage. They weren't able to accomplish that on that last drive. So each team has to be a little bit more clean.
Fair catch call for inside the 35. So they're clearly not going to kick it to River Peppers as Tucker, the wide receiver, a backup wide receiver, calls for the fair catch. And you can't blame him. Peppers is already struck for a 16-yard touchdown run. And here comes Kyle Wilson and the offense back out for Fort Osage. Once again, they started the season at 1-3. And I asked Coach Bolt, I said, what was going on in those first games? Well, we made mistakes, we had turnovers.
Yeah.
And I said, what about the four-game win streak? Not as many mistakes. He's right to the point, very blunt. And no mince words, as here's Peppers. Not much doing there. Good job there on the defensive line. It was Westling. Brandis was flying in with a defensive end. Let's say he's a college prospect on the NAIA level.
Well, you mentioned how Coach was pretty cut and dry. That's how it was in my conversation. And I love those coaches. Like, they are so focused. Each of the coaches were up late watching film last night, carved out some time to chat with me, but they're about the business at hand.
And a running play this time. As they get a new running back in the ball game, Lake Sullivan. He's a bigger back at 185 pounds.
Look at the closing speed by Caden Fields.
Yep.
Right there, number 32. Red reacted, made the play, creating third down.
He's the Will linebacker, leads the team in tackles for a loss, and now third down and seven. We got a bunch set wide receivers short side.
Try to run the ball that way.
Quarterback in trouble and going to be sacked back near the 30-yard line. And I think that was your guy Brandis again there. No, let's see who they're giving the sack to.
There's so much pressure in the face of the quarterback there. Really no time to scan the field. Again, a Northman party in the backfield for Fort Osage. Defense really stepping up. Excellent job.
The All-Stater Jalen Williams, credit for the sack and a block of the punt. Fort Osage has picked it up, though. This ball is live. And can they run for the first down? Yes, they will, near midfield. So the ball takes a room service hop for Xander Shepherd, who actually is a, you know, an active player as a linebacker. He is alert here, Dana, and picks it up and runs for the first down.
Yeah, excellent awareness. You can see the penetration there by the block punt.
The ball just landed right back in his lap.
Yeah, that was Jordan Bruce that got his hand on it, blocked the punt, and then excellent awareness and tough running. I mean, that was a fourth down and long situation. He's able to get that first down, and the Indians rotate their offense back on the field. That's a huge play for Fort Osage.
It's an 18-yard return of the block punt by Xander Shepherd. The ball to 49, and whistles prior to the snap.
It's going to be a conference. I want to say that there's probably talking about the advancement of the punt. Because the ball was actually punted, the question is, can they advance it? My understanding is, because the ball was blocked and it was still behind the line of scrimmage, you can advance the ball. Now, had that ball gone forward past the line of scrimmage, then the punting team could not advance it. But it is kind of a convoluted rule because the ball was actually punted. And technically, as soon as the ball touches the foot of the punter, they are now on defense. And what we saw here with Jordan Bruce, watch the penetration up the middle, high snap, gets right up the middle, gets a little skinny there, gets his left hand on the ball. Now that went backwards, actually. So it went backwards back to the punter. Therefore, he can advance it forward. And that's where we stand right now. But I understand the conversation and clarity. That's my understanding, Kevin, of the rule. We'll see how it all unfolds here.
Both coaches getting explained what is going on the field. I thought it was a legitimate advance. And Shepherd, like I said, you know, it's chaos. It's disaster. You've had your punt block, and the ball lands right in his lap. And he said, I'm going to run it up the field for 18 and a first down.
Yeah, he slithered through the line, broke multiple tackles to get the first down, keep the momentum on the side of the Indians. They sent both teams to the sidelines as the officials are going to gather together to make sure they got the play call right.
Details. Coach Carr there, the veteran coach, waits with his Indians. And again, the official still talking about this play, a block punt and advancement of the football. Senior night here at Oak Park. We've got cancer awareness, a lot of people wearing pink. There's a chili cook-off contest between the football players and the band. So, yeah, there you see all the pink.
Yeah, it's great to see the student body come together, all uniform for great causes, great awareness. You see that at the NFL level, even at the college level. A lot of the players, they got pink leg bands on, socks, et cetera, representing that great cause also.
Defense coming back out now for Oak Park. Charlie Pugh is the defensive coordinator. They're giving up 21 points per game, 267 yards per game. Let's check in with Les.
Dana, I just heard you talking about what you called the convoluted rule. I mean, with between high school, college, and the NFL, it's all different. But Coach Oak Park head coach was looking at him and one of his assistant coaches were looking at the rules on his phone trying to figure out if that was the right rule or not. So I think you nailed it, Danon.
Technology at work down on the sidelines.
First and 10. And not much running room for Peppers. He is clogged up, may lose yardage as he's thrown down on the play.
Oh,
speaking of which, Danon, you have to know the high school, college, and the professional level, because that's what your three broadcasts are this weekend.
Yeah, it's going to be a busy weekend. It's alumni slash legends weekend for the Chiefs, as you see the toss down right there.
Congratulations, Dante Hall.
Yep, Dante Hall being inducted into the Ring of Honor. But I got a college game tomorrow, UNI versus University of North Dakota. Then I got a Chiefs and Chargers Sunday. So, yeah, it's going to be a little bit busy.
No gain on that last run. Second down and 10. And now flags fly.
Flag on the play.
Delay of game. Offense number 15. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
He's lost track of the play clock located at the right corner of each end zone. Normally when you break the huddle, most of the players, not just the quarterback, recognize where they are on the clock, but a lot of communication comes from the sideline with these coaches, so you can kind of get away from the awareness.
Wilson, second down and 15, pass, short one, is caught. Making the catch there was Snodgrass, the junior wide receiver, his fifth catch of the year.
Gained 4 yards on the play. That brings
a gain of four. Was tackled immediately there by Emmanuel Koch, who leads the Northmen with 6 interceptions in 8 games.
What a season he's had.
Yep.
Secure the ball, trying to get a little bit of the chunk back so you're not in a severe hole on third down.
Down and 11, setting up a screen pass. Sullivan the catch, and he is pushed out of bounds. That was developing into a nicely play there, but Oak Park able to make the play and push him out of bounds. Sullivan, the fullback, a little screen pass.
A little jailbreak screen. You're allowing the Northmen to get pressure in the face of the quarterback. Quarterback buys time by backing up, but excellent discipline by the Northmen defense. Man-to-man coverage, forcing a fourth down.
Cam Wall, the Mike linebacker, leading tackler, was the guy that escorted him out and forces a punt on fourth down. This one away cleanly. No block this time by the Northman, but it's a very short punt to the sideline. And it'll be Oak Park getting the football back here late in the first quarter. 7-7 score in this suburban Red Conference matchup. This football at the 22, only a 24-yard punt. And Aiden Hinkle, star of the first drive, running the football.
He'll have it.
Now they mark it back to the 20-yard line. First and 10. And they're going to have Braxton and Pankey in the backfield. They line up in a, what you never see anymore, the standard I formation. Yeah. Pankey.
I never really understood that alignment, Kevin, because with the shotgun formation or pistol, you got running backs up to 10 yards, 9 yards back. So even if you have a lead draw, that gives the defense so much time to be able to attack the line of scrimmage, as we saw the Indians there. I guess I'm old school, like to line up the quarterback under center and get the running back going downhill with a full head of steam.
Second down and 7 after the 3-yard Pankey run. Here's Hinkle running to the edge and taken down nicely there. That is Mauricio Bears, the safety man, taking the Oak Park quarterback down. And it's going to be third down and long.
And this is the exact defense you want to see. You see the linebacker right there, number 57. His eyes are totally on the running back, Isaac Fields, that linebacker. And then, as you mentioned, Beers coming downhill from that safety position. His responsibility is the quarterback.
Now third down and 9, under a minute to go in your first quarter. Hinkle, screen pass, deflected away. And I think that was Owen Robertson who got his hands on it. Batting it away, number 35, the DN for the Indians.
Senior, 6'1", 201-pound defensive end. Another attempt at a jailbreak screen, but great discipline and going high to get the right hand on it. Got his paw on it to force fourth down.
Trey Smith back deep for the Indians.
Hinkle, quarterback slash punter, and that's a good high punt. And midfield fair catch called for. And that is Penniman with the fair catch. And it's going to be a 32-yard punt and no return. And the offense coming back out. This one at the late stages of your first quarter. Winner wins the conference this year. As far as the districts go, Fort Osage is class 5. So they're in a different class. Oak Park is class 6, probably going to get the top spot more than likely. Fort Osage, though, they're in a number 2 slot, and they got Platte County breathing down their neck. Green Valley is the top team in their class 5 district, so still a lot to play for tonight in this final regular season game. Yes. Peppers. I'll check that Ward with the run. No gain on the play.
Well, you mentioned it earlier, Kevin. This is a little bit of a revenge game. Fort Osage, they've been dominant in this matchup for a long time, and the Northmen, they want to announce themselves as a force, and it's not a mistake that they are undefeated so far.
Ward with a nice run, close to the first down. Ward, who's an excellent wrestler, but his sister is the star athlete of the family. Haley Ward is going to Iowa as a college wrestler after 4 straight state titles for the Indians. After 1, all even at 7. Ready for the start of the second quarter. Suburban Red action on the Hy-Vee High School game of the week here on Spectrum News. Kevin White, Dana Hughes, and Les Norman. And here's River Peppers. Not much running room tonight other than that 16-yard touchdown run. They've kept him kind of bottled up. You don't want this guy with his 4.43 40 speed to get loose.
Yeah. What you're seeing from the Northmen, Kevin, is rally tackling. You very rarely have seen one Northman tackle the ball carrier for Fort Osage. It's been 3 or 4 blue helmets around the football. I even heard the coaches talk about get the ball out, exactly what you want to do when you have rally tackling. First guy, hold him up. Second, third, fourth guy, try to rip the ball out.
Coach getting to the edge. They ran short side with that quick pitch and just Peppers, no running room here.
Yeah, with the team speed by the Northman defense, as you see number 32 there, Caden Fields, tough to run short side even with the speed that we've seen displayed by River Peppers.
Actually lost yardage. It's now 3rd down and 10. Indians.
This is tough for anybody, never mind a heavy run team, to be at the sticks or behind the sticks. Obvious passing situations.
Quick pass to the flat. There's Penniman with the catch. Penniman with the yards after the catch again. Penniman been a hurtful wide receiver for that Oak Park secondary, and just great speed here and run after the catch.
Yeah, design play with blocking downfield, but look at the block by Snodgrass right there. He opens up the door for the big gain and first down. Penniman coming through with another big play, but he's got to give his props to his other buddies at that wide receiver position. It's so tough to stalk block for that long, but Snodgrass made it look easy.
So on 3rd down and 10, he goes for 23 yards and a first down. Here's Peppers on a cutback, and he is blasted on the play. And say hello to Fields, the Will linebacker. And Dana, he's had a big ball game this week.
Yeah, we've said his name multiple times, and here's why. Square up, textbook tackle, drive your legs, shoulder into the ball and into the gut. That's one, a solo tackle, very rare for the Northmen, but perfectly done.
Second leading tackler on the team. Here's Peppers. Again, nice cutback. And this is what makes him so special as he carries tacklers. He's not the biggest guy in the world, goes a 180, but he finishes this run, and it's a first down. And he thought, well, he's going to get close to the first down, and then he's past the stakes.
Yep. Plant this right foot, get north and south. Taking on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 defenders. Tackle made by Churchill Coates, the senior defensive back there, but a tough run for River Peppers.
And first and 10, here's River trying to cut back again. It's clogged up in the middle. Not getting much there. He has the 16-yard rushing touchdown. He was first-team All-Conference, second-team All-State.
Number 22 getting tackled by number 22, Khalil Gill, the senior outside linebacker, driving him backwards there. Been tough sledding at times for the Indians in the run game against Northman.
Tackle for a loss, second down and long. As they're looking at 11 or 12. As they try to grab the lead here early second quarter, do the Indians on the road. Wilson, the pass deflected. And when the ball pops in the air, the eyes light up in the Oak Park secondary, but it falls incomplete.
That's Emmanuel Koch there, the junior defensive back, just lost the vision of the ball. This is could have been an easy interception. Watch the deflection up front. He's standing right there. It falls right at his left foot. Just did not see the ball at all. Missed opportunity for the Northmen.
What's the rule? Deflections turn into INTs usually. Not this time. Now third down and 12. As here's Wilson rolling, throwing, and the pass incomplete. Went with a check down. I think he went with Penniman there, and he couldn't hang on. So it's going to be a fourth down, and let's see if they want to try a field goal attempt.
I think the design here with that spot route, Kevin, is maybe trying to get a large portion of that back and get into a fourth down and three or four where the Indians might have gone for it. But as you mentioned, going to try the field goal here. Looks like a 30-yard field goal attempt.
Well, I'm going to go
31.
31. I'm going to give Xander Shepherd a little extra yard here. And this field goal is up and good. His long of the season was 32, and that one just creeped over the bar and puts his team in front here at 10-7 in the early part of the second quarter. And a game that will decide who wins the conference crown in 2023. Xander Shepherd has come up big, Danen. The block punt that he ran for a first down, and now the 31-yard field goal puts his team in front.
You have to capitalize when you get into that red zone. I used to call it the gold zone. Tim Grunhard, Ring of Honor guy for the Chiefs, a longtime Kansas City Chiefs center. Kind of coined the phrase as the gold zone. I think he got it from Notre Dame when he was in college. So we adopted it like you're going for gold. When you're going in for a touchdown, you're going for gold. But now it's really referred to as the red zone. When you get into that red zone, you got to capitalize with points.
And they got three. Third field goal make of the year for Xander. He's now 3 for 4. First team all-conference kicker and also a punter. Now the Northmen will get their chance.
Back deep to Northmen, 15 TK Douglas. Number 7, Heather Braxton.
Braxton and Douglas, the deep men.
Kicking off for the Indians.
No real wind to speak of tonight. Very calm night in Kansas City. Beautiful fall night. And from the 10-yard line on the return. And that's a nice return for the Northmen.
TK
Douglas, a junior, one of their fastest guys. Only goes 135 pounds, but shows some good speed here and breaks a tackle.
Yeah, toughness too. A little ping pong action there, secured the football, got extra yards after contact. A little jolt of energy for the Northmen and great field position for them to start this drive.
Ball at the 34, first and 10. They employ a fullback, which is another old school thing that you don't see much in football. Here's Pankey, and Pankey showing good vision. Pankey down the left hash, getting some blocks down the field, and finally knocked out by Landon Lamb, but not after a big time run. and shows good patience and then turns on the speed, but give the wide receiver some credit down the field, some good blocks.
Yeah, many people don't realize how tough it is to stalk block downfield, but how about the offensive lineman getting downfield? We see big number 77, Xavier Kearns, the senior downfield, and then tough for Evan Cook to have to sustain that drive. Another senior sustain that job of blocking, but they get just enough done for another huge game.
45 yards and a first down. Ball at the 31. And this is a run by Pankey again. Pankey into space. Pankey to the house. Touchdown, Northman. 31 yards. T. Pankey.
Trayvon Pankey with just picking, poking, prodding, and then the burst of speed to get the job done, taking it to pay dirt. Two huge runs for the junior running back.
And Matt Solario, the senior, left-footed kicker, drills it through, 14-10, home team on senior night, Oak Park. Back in front.
Yep. How about the offensive line? Let's give him some love on that right side. Adrian Garcia, Xavier Kearns getting it done, and then the plant and getting back downhill. Deceptive speed there by Pankey. Good long stride. You can see right there, no chance. Anytime you got a defense swimming after you, that's tough sledding. Great job, great execution by the offense for the Northmen. Five carries, 83 yards. We got 9 minutes and 9 seconds left in the second quarter, Kevin.
That's his second rushing touchdown of the night, 24th of the year. First team all-conference junior running back, getting college looks as well. And now it's River Pepper's turn as he goes back to retrieve this kick, but they have not been kicking to him by design. They been kicking to the up men. Solario to kick off here, the left-footed kicker. Culp is the right-footed kicker. So again, this is a directional short kick taken at the 24-yard line by one of the up men. And this is Penniman. He's a dangerous guy with the ball. Penniman across midfield for a 28-yard return. So the counter, Danen, is to put our dangerous guys in those little short spots, and Penniman makes them pay.
Yeah, you got to scan the field, know your personnel. Excellent job, and this is what we've seen from Penniman this evening. Breaking tackles, we also seen excellent effort on what could have been a touchdown-saving tackle by the starting linebacker, Caden Fields, covering kicks.
Well, that is good coaching there. Normally you have a backup DB or a backup linebacker as a blocker there. Now you put a explosive player by Penniman, and he retrieves it for that long 28-yard.
Dead ball, false start. Offense, number 54. 5-yard penalty, first down.
That's the third one that they've had so far in this game.
Pre-snap penalty.
Pre-snap.
They're killers.
Illegal motion or false starts by the offense. Got to clean that up.
Yeah, that's goes in the category of mistakes that cost them that 1-3 start. Turnovers, penalties. But since then, they've cleaned it up, won four in a row. And now down on the road, 14-10 to conference rival Oak Park. It'll be a 1st and 15 back to the 45-yard line. Peppers, and he is taken down immediately. Tell you what, this guy, Dom Coot, the junior, gets his 6th tackle for a loss. He is the 3 technique or nose tackle.
Yeah, look, he just got through, missed blocking assignment up front, tracks down the ball carrier there. Coot getting it done, the junior defensive lineman.
Loss of 3, now it's 2nd down and 18. River Peppers makes a tackle. Good second effort up to midfield. Gain to the 49-yard line, a gain of 7. Still, it's going to be 3rd down and long for the Indians.
That's all you can expect there on 2nd down after the negative play, the penalty. get a chunk of it back, get into a third down, and what looks like 11 yards here. Still tough sledding for the Indians. This is multiple times in this game, Kevin, where we've seen them at third and 10 plus. Been successful at times, but it's uphill.
Yeah, it's behind the chains. Penniman bailed them out in the first quarter. And here's Penniman. A hit as the ball arrives there. That's Coates. Now, the question is, was he early on his hit on the receiver? No, we'll have to take another look at this. Penniman had no shot here, Dana, and he was level in the play.
This is number three, Donovan Ross, the junior defensive back, comes up with the clean hit. I think it was simultaneous there. Excellent job and instincts by Ross to dislodge the ball, forcing fourth down.
Good call, Ross, their top cover corner. First team all-conference, and again, Shepard has to act quickly and send this one to the sideline. Short punt, and Oak Park will get the football as they'll spot it at the 28-yard line, 23 yards on the punt. Now Hinkle and the offense back out. Hankey was the big star their last drive. As he got the 31-yard score after a 45-yard run. Run again with Pankey. Made a good point on him. It doesn't look like he's moving that fast, but he is a long strider, and he is covering up some ground there on that field turf. But when you look at him from our side angle view, it looks like, he's not running that hard.
Well, I played against a guy in college and in the pros with the Vikings at Ohio State, Robert Smith, a running back that didn't look fast, but he found a way with those long strides to pull away from guys. And obviously, the great Marcus Allen, who played here, was one of those guys as well.
And he got a quiet five. Now Hinkle, the late pitch. And, oh, man, Pankey got leveled on the play. Lose 2 yards in this play, but this was a dangerous pitch, late pitch.
Yeah, late pitches can be devastating against the speed defense right there. And you see Vincent White, the sophomore corner, coming up with the big tackle.
Good story there. A guy that played C-team ball last year now starts on the varsity. So it's not how you start your career.
Just keep grinding.
This is a kid that's worked really hard and improved. And it's going to be third down, and they still need 7 yards.
They had Fort Osage had to rotate out Thompson, the linebacker, Anthony Thompson.
Their leading tackler.
Yeah, I think he may have had blood coming from a cut or something, so he's getting tended to on the sideline. I'm sure Les may be able to see what's going on that account.
And now we get a timeout on the field. Of course, Thompson is the younger brother of Skylar Thompson, former K-State quarterback, now Miami Dolphin quarterback.
I got a chance to talk with Coach Bolt about the leaders on this team, and Thompson was one of them. He said not just a leader in stats, but also in attitude, work ethic, committed to the program. He, Peppers, and Gallman, the three leaders that came to his mind. Gallman, a great story. Defensive lineman, offensive line, had to fill in at different times, different positions. They don't have very many players that play both sides, a two-platoon system that's pretty prevalent in high school football nowadays. Every once in a while, you get a guy that can do both.
After the timeout, charge to nobody, third down and 7. Hinkle, flush, throwing across the middle, has a man wide open. And guess who? Big play, Evan Braxton. Forget about it, to the house. As he breaks the tape at the goal line, and they strike with this big play by their big play wide receiver, Evan Braxton, 69 yards on a third down and long.
Well, that's an outstanding job by Hinkle, reading the defense, pressure in his face, having to avoid the sack, but knew where Braxton was. And once Braxton, when we get to this highlight, you talk about opening up the gates as a track star. Braxton, speed, pulling away from that defense.
Extra point.
My goodness.
Splits the uprights, but yeah, you talk about he caught it at midfield. There were guys around him for like a moment. And on senior night, this is a big play for senior Evan Braxton.
Watch this. Excellent job, Hinkle, scanning the field, pressure, sees it out the corner of his eye, and then it's off to, I don't even want to call this the races, because he makes the entire Fort Osage defense look a little bit slower. That speed kills, and Braxton gets the job done from midfield. Full speed, great strides, no chance to track him down. Break through the tape at the end.
Let's check in with Les.
Guys, you want to talk about somebody that makes somebody feel old. Evan Braxton caught that ball. He had to stop and wait for it because Aiden Hinkle had to throw off of his backside across his body. Evan Braxton waited for that. Two Fort Osage defenders were either even or behind him, had the angle. He turned around and still outran them and gained probably 7 to 10 yards past them. What an incredible athlete. My goodness, I think I might put this down and just go weep in the car.
7th receiving touchdown of the year. And now here's Thompson on the return. Thompson finding space down the left half of the field before he's tackled. So again, Fort Osage is moving up their big stars into the short kicking zone. And Thompson, who had a 69-yard return earlier this year, shows his worth on a kickoff return.
Well, we've seen this multiple times for Fort Osage. Short kicks by the Northmen, and Fort Osage makes the kickoff coverage team pay with solid field position. That's a great job by the middle linebacker.
Well, I think people...
Athletes. They're athletes.
His brother, Skylar Thompson, could run like the wind. And he had some injuries at K-State, kind of slowed down his rushing ability, but when he was at Fort Osage, he could... Oh, yeah. He was a 4-5 kid. And his little brother showing some good speed there. Here's Peppers. Short side, not much doing as he is a run out of bounds.
Looked like a little extra on the sideline there by Churchill. Coates, the defensive back.
Now, Coates is their third leading tackler. He's the senior free safety. There's no love here. These are conference rivals. Winner wins the conference for 2023. Second down and 8. Motion by Penniman. They fake the jet sweep. Now Wilson steps up and going down at the 35-yard line as the defensive lineman Tate Ruth, the junior, 5'11", 230, will get credit for the tackle.
Good persistence there by Ruth getting it done. And it was interesting. I watched the receivers downfield. There were 3 receivers all within 10 yards of each other on the short side of the field. So really no chance for a receiver, a viable receiver downfield. Now we're at 3rd down and 10 again.
Wilson now scanning the field, loops a pass down the field. That's a dangerous ball. It's deflected and nearly intercepted. And they were looking for Snodgrass there, but that had some hang time on it.
Yep.
And that allowed the DBs to get in the air. I thought Cope maybe was going to get an interception here. Let's see.
It almost got intercepted, then caught right there.
Yeah.
You could have had a deflection into the hands of Curtis Holloway.
Yeah, Curtis was frustrated there. And Donovan Ross in the secondary nearly had the interception. But instead, now it's going to be 4th down and 10, under 5 to play. Coming up, we got Hy-Vee at the half. Numbers and highlights brought to you by your employee-owned Hy-Vee stores. Looks like they'll go for it on 4th down and 10. Wilson in trouble, and Wilson staying alive. Wow. And the pass down the field broken up. Well, now they're saying it is a catch. Oh, my gosh.
Wow.
Penniman makes the catch here. How many Houdini plays are there on this play? Wilson avoiding the rush, and then Penniman making the catch here.
A lot to dissect here. Great pressure. The avoidability by the quarterback there. Gets open and then just takes a chance. That's exactly what you want to do. The ball goes through the hands.
Oh, my goodness.
Of Snodgrass into the hands of Penniman. Watch what happens at the end of this, Kevin.
26 yards and a first down on fourth down and 10, Dane. And
got to take a chance. Right through the hands and into the face mask and chest. Outstanding job of focus right there. Made a big play.
Unbelievable. Well, I didn't think Wilson would get away from the rush. And he, Harry Houdini'd his way from that. And then the ball goes through a guy's hands and hits a guy in the face mask and kind of sticks to his chest. And that's Penniman for 26 yards and a first down as we get a timeout on the field. Our team's down to two timeouts as points going to be big here. Fort Osage can score here before halftime. As we saw Oak Park starting to grab this game as far as the momentum in this game. They're big plays from Pankey and Braxton, but.
Well, this is huge, as you mentioned, because Oak Park gets the ball coming out for the third quarter after winning the coin toss. So you don't want to give them two consecutive or three consecutive opportunities to score without scoring against them.
Under center. And Peppers is blown up, tackle for a loss. Fields having a big game, the Will linebacker. And it'll be second down and goal to go back to the 13-yard line.
Yeah, that's a great run blitz by Caden Fields. Really no chance for Lake Sullivan, the fullback, who's responsible for that middle linebacker in that I formation. Didn't even have a chance to adjust his blocking path. Fields showing that speed, getting in the backfield.
Second down and goal to go. Now Peppers in motion as a receiver. Pass is caught. And the ball is on the field. Did they say he was down? It was Penniman the catch. Penniman with the catch. Now the ball came out after it looks like he hit the ground here. Let's see, Dane. In the
Little spot route there. The ball looked like his knee was down.
Yep, the ball.
He's able to get the ball back anyway.
Yep.
Third down.
Fields another defensive play. Now third down and goal to go from the five, and the running play is stuffed. Now Fort Osage, we saw him convert on fourth down and 10. Now gonna have to convert on fourth down and goal from the 5-yard line.
Looks like they're gonna go. Oh, they're gonna go for it. They went for it on fourth and 10.
Well, I see the kicker is out there, Shepard. And now they're gonna instead take a timeout. It's gonna be an Oak Park timeout. So now we saw the kicker, Shepard, who's hit from 31. Earlier in the half.
I don't have a problem with this one, Kevin. I don't have a problem with
you're going to take the points.
Well, I don't have the problem with them calling a timeout with 2 minutes, 34 seconds left. Hadn't used a timeout, or I should say used only one timeout. Not going to take any into the locker room with you. May keep one. You got a strong left leg kicker. If you're able to get the ball back and get it into field goal range, you have that one timeout. But make sure your guys are aware not to run into the kicker, commit any penalties here to give any extra life to the Indians.
Spotted at the 11. It'll be a 21-yard attempt. Shepard is hit from 31. Placement is good. Kick is up and through. And it's three more for Fort Osage just before halftime. 21-yard field goal, Xander Shepard.
An excellent drive for the Indians, getting points on the board. They're not getting as big of plays chunk plays as we've seen from the Northmen, but they just kind of stick around. Pesky team, tough, hard-nosed team, great history at Fort Osage. And what the Northmen knew was going to happen coming into this game is we knew they were going to fight. They're going to battle and stick around. The pesky teams are the teams that figure out ways to put themselves in position to win late in game. So that's a great job. Great 8-play, 30-yard drive for a field goal.
Started with the Thompson kickoff return. And now here comes the special teamers for Fort Osage as they check out on the field for the kickoff. So a good return by T.K. Douglas. Evan Braxton and T.K. Douglas, the deep man, and this is a squib kick. And will be fielded at the 21-yard line. So again, the special teams coach is reluctant to kick to the deep men because you know, you got Braxton back there, and then you got River Peppers on the other side. So
that's a risky kick, though, because if that ball doesn't get back to that third level and take that high bounce, you run the risk of the Northmen getting the ball closer to the 40-yard line and only having to go, you know, a short set of yards to get to a field goal range.
8-yard kickoff return. And Oak Park offense back out. Three backs in the backfield. Hinkle to the edge. And Hinkle spun down. Thompson running down that play, the Mike linebacker. And the best in the city, and you see why there on this play.
Yeah, good sideline to sideline speed. We heard about Anthony Thompson and what he's able to do, his prowess on the field, his speed, toughness. Shows it right there.
4.0 GPA plus, pound for pound, the strongest guy on the team. And he's saddled with the moniker of Skylar Thompson's little brother, but he can play as well. Pass down the field, and Braxton can't get to that. Fans want a flag, and there is a flag down in the secondary now.
We haven't seen very many flags outside of false starts and illegal motions on the side of Fort Osage, but it looks like they're going to call
pass interference. Defense number 21. 15-yard, result of play, first down.
You heard the grumbling and rumbling from the crowd, and the flag came out.
Yep. Trying to go over the top. Speed we saw earlier, just a lot of handsy, extra hands to try to slow down the speedy Evan Braxton. Officials right on top of it.
Moves it out to the 44-yard line. First and 10. Northmen leading 21-13 on their senior night. All kinds of things going on. There's a lot of people here tonight. This second year, excellent facility, the Oak Park Activities Complex.
Ooh.
And this running play, Pankey is ankle tackle from behind. And that time, that was Landon Sullivan, the defensive end, tracking down Pankey and making a nice stop here.
How about the senior getting after it right here? It's a little like Chris Jones there, tracking down the ball carrier from behind. Landon Sullivan, 5'11", 215 pounds.
Met the new basketball coach here at Oak Park, Sharon Collins. And Braxton, the diving catch on the sideline. EB, another big play for the Northmen. As he lays out and goes and gets this ball down to the 21-yard line.
Going to the well again, recognizing the speed of Evan Braxton. He's able to reel that in. Might have gotten shortchanged a little bit on the yardage. Got to the 20-yard line right there, but outstanding effort, concentration, awareness on how close he was to the sideline. Just a straight go route past Vincent White.
They give him 36 yards, so to go along with that 69-yard catch and run, he's over 100 yards receiving. Pankey the patient run up the middle, kind of backs his way inside the 15-yard line to the 14. Gain of 7, second down and short. As the clock approaching a minute to play before Hy-Vee at the half. See how they manage this.
I'm sorry, this is when it gets tough, when you got the communication coming from the sideline. How much time is used trying to get everybody aligned and on the same page?
Hinkle, second down and short, pass caught inside the 5-yard line. And it's going to be first and goal, as that's Clemens' second catch of the game. The coach's son, we saw that highlight, you know, climbing the ladder catch. Now he's got it down to the 4-yard line, make it the 3, first and goal. Northman trying to get points before halftime. Pankey, cut back, not going to get there. Thompson made a tough one-on-one tackle there, as that's just Pankey against Thompson. And Thompson able to deny him the 6.
And Northman call their final timeout of the first half with 19 seconds left. May have enough time to run 2 plays here, Kevin, depending on what the first play is. Good smart call by Coach Clemens to call a timeout. Maybe call 2 plays right now. Let them know, hey, run this play. If it's not a negative play but not a touchdown, hurry up. Get into a quarterback sneak, something like that. You got, you know, Aiden back there that Hinkle can run the ball as well. You don't need to get any too crafty here. Ball is inside, or it looks like right on the 1-yard line, right?
Yep. Be second down and goal. Northman line it up. 19 seconds to go, second quarter. And they'll go with Pankey, pounds the right side. He's in, touchdown. Trayvon Pankey, 1-yard touchdown run. And that is his 3rd of the night.
Pretty close here, whether he's short or not. He drops that right shoulder, keeps trying, actually, his knee never touched. He just continued to churn those legs right there. Reached the ball across the goal line. Tough, tough run.
Yeah, he was on top of Levi Walker, the linebacker, as the extra point up and good. Pankey, a 3-touchdown night, 25 on the year, as we take another look.
Watch this, good blocking up front. Outstanding job at the point of attack. Xavier Kearns, Adrian Garcia, and then the tough run, churning those legs to get past the goal line. What a drive. 8 plays, 71 yards, and 2 minutes, 13 seconds. And they get the ball coming out for the 3rd quarter. Got to be careful here. May see the Northman try to roll the dice just a bit, maybe with a squib kick up front. Surprise onside with only 15 seconds left. Fort Osage has 2 timeouts.
Let's see how they want to handle this kickoff. They have not been kicking deep. Now they will send it to the 20-yard line with Penniman. And Penniman got that great speed across the 30 to the 34-yard line. 14 yards on the kickoff return.
11 yards on the return.
Cam Wall with the big hit right there. Looks like Penniman came up a little bit limping there. Can't afford to have him go down. Tough kid. Now 10 seconds left. Have to believe that Fort Osage will likely play it safe.
Well, last year, Fort Osage had the most dangerous guy in the city on kickoff returns in Lorenzo Fenner. He's now at the University of South Dakota along with his teammate, Roman Tillman. Talking about coaches saying we never wanted to kick it to Fenner, as now they'll just take a knee and take it into the halftime locker room. Down 28-13 will Fort Osage on senior night here at Oak Park. Winner wins the conference for 2023. As this final regular season game, still fighting for those district standings on a pink out here at Oak Park. And we'll have your Hy-Vee at the half coming up here momentarily. We'll have the numbers and the highlights brought to you by your employee-owned Hy-Vee stores. And we have our Hy-Vee halftime coaches interview. And that's with Les Norman and Ken Clemens.
Coach Clemens, 15-point lead. Got the running game, seems like it's pretty solid, but you're also using the passing game pretty well. Evan Braxton flying out there, making some great catches with some good athleticism from Aiden Hinkle.
Yep, you know, they've been playmakers all year when they've been asked to do it. And you know, a big game like this, you got to go ahead and take those shots.
So you deferred for the second half with that 15-point lead. Now you got the ball coming out. What's the game plan coming? Do you continue to stretch it out and put the pressure on?
We want to run the ball. You know, we want to possess the ball. We want to get out of here with a W. They're really good, and it seems like there's some they're getting some breaks, and hopefully the breaks will swing to us.
But you seem like you've done a pretty good job of River Peppers isolating him just a little bit. Only a couple big runs there, so that's a pretty good defensive stand there.
Yeah, that's one of those so far.
So far. All right, well, good luck second half.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Coach. Thanks, Les. Senior night here at Oak Park. Chad Valadez, the activities director. Got to be happy with the first half. His team leads it 28-13 at the break. Hy-Vee at the half coming up next. Hy-Vee proud to support Kansas City High School Athletics. Big long line there to get some chow at halftime. Dana Hughes was in there earlier.
Yep.
He got a nice chicken sandwich that he wolfed down here before our broadcast.
Very quickly, a chicken sandwich, Kevin.
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm mispronouncing it. You're right. 28-13, Oak Park is in front, and they'll get the football. And Ken Clemens, in that interview with Les, said the ball game's still not over, but I feel like this team's kind of taking charge in this game, but this will be a big drive to start the third quarter. As far as the Northmen, they'll get the football to start the third quarter.
Yeah, it's huge course of events for the Northmen, being able to score these last couple of drives and then have the opportunity to create more distance here to open up the second half.
Well, the kicker is getting warmed up, Culp, but the guy that really lit up the first half was Trayvon Pankey for the Northmen.
Yeah, he did an outstanding job. Great blocking up front. Look at the push by the offensive line for the Northmen. Those guys getting it done. Mahdi, Garcia, Kearns, Williams, and Westing. Opening up the door for Trayvon Pankey, 11 carries, 95 yards, and 3 touchdowns. Such a great push up front. Makes it easy for the running back.
Senior night 2023 for Oak Park for their band and their football team. And the football and the band, I guess they're having a chili cook-off contest over by the high school. There's a lot of people here tonight dressed in pink for cancer awareness. And you're impressed by these facilities. These are brand new facilities here. It's only their second year. And I'm telling you, this is great setup they have here at Oak Park High School now.
Absolutely.
Getting to play their games at their high school, that was big. They always had to travel to North Kansas City or Staley to play their games. Now they get to play right in front of their fans on their home field.
And you can tell there's a lot of pride into this field, a lot of support, fans, parents, boosters. Great to see. Love the high school atmosphere, man.
Well, good to have you back. We had some people need the night off, and you and Les stepped up to help us out. I know you got a busy weekend. You got a college game tomorrow, and then the Chiefs on Sunday. And so we appreciate you stepping in and helping us out here. As here comes the Northmen through the tunnel and coming back out. Fort Osage back out.
It's great to be back. Great to be a part of this broadcast, Spectrum News. Back with you. We go way back, 20 plus years?
Oh, yeah.
Les and I, great friends as well. Both loving baseball and football.
Yeah, I was going to say, when's the B word coming up here? The baseball theme would come up, and actually we saw the baseball field here they call the yard. They're redoing that. Yeah. They're putting the field turf. And they're doing the softball field as well. So a lot of renovations going on here at Oak Park as here comes Coach Clemens back out. And well, let's send it down to Les for another coach's interview brought to you by Hy-Vee.
Thanks, guys. Talk with Fort Osage coach Brock Bolt on the way out. He obviously wasn't too happy. And I said, okay, what did you tell him at halftime? He didn't talk about any players. He didn't highlight anybody. What he said was, we need to be more physical. We need to tackle more. They're running all over the place on us, so it's time to step that part of the game up.
Coach Bolt and his sons, Brody and Williams. I think Coach goes from coaching his high school team to coaching his son's team as well. I mean, these guys, the energy levels in these guys. Williams is playing the tackle football. He's like, wrapping up the interview with me. I got to go coach another practice, my son's practice. So
he took a lot of pride in his sons, both of his sons, being on the sideline, as you mentioned, Brody and William. It's a family affair for Coach Bolt, and he takes a lot of pride in it. I just asked him about, you know, what's going on, not just with the program and at the school, and he mentioned his family being important to him, and there's so much time dedicated. You know this. You've been around the game for so long. So much time dedicated, even at the high school level, to coaching these young men. Well, it's always great to be able to add in your family. Coach Clemens is coaching his son on the field, and Coach Bolt has his sons helping him with as ball boys.
Yep, Coach Clemens, it's a, you know, it's a homecoming for him. I mean, he graduated here in 1986. His wife is a counselor, Julie, and a son, like you said, playing. Currently, Drew had a couple of catches in the first half, so he loves being here at Oak Park. He's a Northman through and through. Brock Bolt, Green Valley grad. He's in the Green Valley Hall of Fame. But I mentioned to both these coaches, you guys are very similar in style and no nonsense. Yep. You like to run the football. You like to play good defense.
Old school.
Yep. Kind of the old school mentality, and they agreed with that. And now Fort Osage down 28-13 at half.
A lot of respect for each of them. Each coach having a lot of respect for the other coach as well. Two blue collar teams fighting hard.
Yep. You know, it was great to talk to Coach Clemens. I said, hey, you know, what I said back in August, you guys are going to be 8-0 there as you approach Halloween. And he said, yeah, we had a chance. We had a lot of guys coming back. A lot of played some young guys over the last few years, and now they've developed. So. But the problem they have is that they got absorbed into Class 6.
Yeah.
And in Class 6, you have Lee Summit North. You have Liberty North. You have Rockhurst. You've got some powerhouse teams. So now Fort Osage, they're Class 5. They don't want to lose that number 2 spot behind Green Valley, but Platte County is breathing down their neck. So it's really interesting in that Class 5 district that they're in. Green Valley is on top. It's the Class 5 District 8. Green Valley got a comfortable lead. They got 47 and a half points to Fort Osage's 39 and a half points. But like I said, Platt County in third spot. So a lot to play for. Still the conference crown on the line tonight. But I mean, I think if you know the Oak Park story, Oak Park hasn't had a winning season since the early 2000s. And Staley opened up. This area kind of, a lot of people left, kind of came a ghost town. Oak Park has rebuilt, and they're back up. 8-0 as Coach Bolt is ready for the start of the second half. And it'll be Shepherd to kick it off. T.K. Douglas and Evan Braxton. The deep men for the Northmen. This one will get into the end zone for a touchback. That one's the two guys were like, you take it, I got it.
A little tricky knuckleball.
Yeah, that ball was curving on those two guys. And
smart decision there by Evan Braxton.
Well, Hinkle and the offense out now. They can put a nail in the, drive a nail in the coffin a little bit here. If they can go down and get a touchdown, it's going to put a team that likes to run the ball in a heavy passing mode. Pankey in the backfield has the three touchdowns. Braxton over 100 yards receiving. He has a touchdown. They shift the fullback over, give it off to Pankey. Pankey to the outside. Gets to the edge before he's finally tackled. As he gets to the 25-yard line.
That's what you want to see. If you're Fort Osage, you want to string things out. Force east-west running by Pankey. He does have that speed, but it's a nice job by Vincent White coming up for the tackle.
He's made several tackles. The sophomore that we talked about, the success story, going from a C-team guy to a varsity starter. Second down and five. And quarterback stumbling on the exchange there and will lose a couple of yards back to the 22.
A negative play. Hadn't seen very many of these by Oak Park here, but you can see just getting tripped up, the feet between Pankey and Hinkle. Drives them back just a bit. Now third down and eight.
First drive of the third quarter. Quarterback on the read, keeping it, finding room, and is tackled from behind by Thompson, and that saved the first down run. Thompson made a nice open field stop. And now it's going to be fourth down and about a yard.
I wonder what the decision will be made here. It's a great job by Hinkle. Giving up some ground and then utilizing that speed. Plant that left foot, get downhill as quickly as possible. But that speed by Anthony Thompson at linebacker position. I really like his play.
Hinkle is the quarterback slash punter. So you don't know what they're going to do here. Looks like they're going to punt the ball. Nope. They're going to run it with Pankey. Pankey is going to be stuffed. He is short. They stop him on fourth down. Fort Osage coming up big here in the third quarter. Pankey's saying he got a bad spot, but I never saw him cross the 30, Dana. And the Fort Osage defense coming up big.
And the officials, excellent job being right on top of it. Give a lot of credit to the front seven of Fort Osage. The Indians right there, great penetration. It looked like Pankey ran into his own offensive lineman. Didn't keep his head up. Watch here, right here, right there. Right there, he drops his helmet, runs right into the backfield. Had a chance to maybe get that yardage, but you can clearly see he did not get past to the 30-yard line. That's a big-time stop for the Indians.
New life for the Indians as they take over. At the 29, first and 10, flags fly as the ball is snapped.
Wide receivers got a little anxious there. It's not
dead
Canada.
Ball. False start. Offense, number four. 5-yard penalty. First down.
That was Penniman.
Trying to put pressure on the defense quickly. Looked like the Indians were going to go to the air again. Try to loosen up this defense of the Northmen.
So it'll be first and 15 with the walk-off. Indians getting the play call from the sideline. Peppers at the right hip of the quarterback, and now again whistles prior to the snap.
Timeout, Fort Osage. That's
now
their
we'll
first
get a
charge timeout
out for Fort Osage.
Called by Fort Osage.
It looks like there's some frustration on the side of the Indians having to call a timeout this early in the second half. Play clock looked like maybe it was winding down, some miscommunication. You have that big time turnover on downs, you want to be able to capitalize, so make sure everybody's on the same page.
Their OC, Atagi, Simon Atagi, is up in the box calling the plays from the press box. Yes. Look at Kyle Wilson in the offense huddling. How big would it be to get some points here?
Huge.
And you're right back in this ball game.
And you basically negated the whole deferring of the coin toss by stopping on downs and getting this great field position.
Got Peppers in a slot position. Sullivan in the backfield goes out on a screen pass. Sullivan has some running room. He's a big burly guy and he pounds his way and gets a lot of the yardage back from the penalty. And Sullivan just out of the backfield as a fullback and 185-pound senior, a nice catch and run.
And go with a little tempo here on the offense. Try to reestablish some rhythm.
Got 10 on that catch and run of the screen pass, and now they're back into a more manageable down and distance. And this is Peppers. And I'll tell you what, he got the ball, hit his little shimmy, and then blue jerseys engulfed him. And it'll be a loss on the play. Third down, they're going to need about 7.
Good solid rally tackling. We saw a lot of that from the Northmen in the first half.
That brings up third down. It's
Khalil Gill, part of
the
party there.
Fans making a lot of noise here at the Oak Park Activities Complex. Wilson again buying time, scrambling, and has running room. And he's inside the 20, the first down run. This guy is showing some Fran Tarkenton-like moves here tonight. Every time you think he's going to be sacked, he's able to get away and this time runs for the first down.
Well, he knows the down and distance. He knows that he has to make a play, and I can appreciate the extra effort. Look at the offensive linemen and the efforts that they're giving all the way through the play. See Mawsey downfield, the senior number 73.
Peppers. Hustling. On the first down run, not much, as there's Cam Wall, the leading tackler, the Mike linebacker, grabbing him. A Fran Tarkenton reference.
Yes, I love it.
These kids are going, who the heck was that? It's a Hall of Famer.
It's a good job of tackling there, shedding blocks at the point of attack. Cam Wall.
Gain of 1. Second down and 9, ball at the 16. This drive started with a fourth down stop. There's the scrambler, Wilson throwing, Peppers the catch, the cutback, River into the end zone, touchdown, 4-0. River Peppers, what a move after the catch, Danan, as he got in, and it's a 16-yard receiving touchdown for the running back slash do-it-all guy, River Peppers.
Well, if you can't get the run game going consistently, get it to the ball carriers or your best ball playmakers in the air. And they're able to do that. A couple of quality passing plays for Fort Osage to get them their second touchdown of the game.
And the PAT by Shepherd right through there. And game on. One score game, 28-20. You need a 2-point conversion, but how about River after the catch.
Yeah, right out of the backfield, just runs a kind of a flare route and then avoids the tackle out in the open field. Looked like Mikey Davis, the senior defensive back, was the one who missed on that tackle. And a nice adjustment, attack the ball closest to where it's coming from. Tough, hard-nosed run into the end zone.
That's his second receiving touchdown of the year. So he's got a 16-yard rushing touchdown in the first quarter and a 16-yard receiving touchdown in the third quarter.
See the drive recap. Five plays, 29 yards because of the stop on downs to open up the second half. A lot of the momentum back shifted to the Indians.
Well, you rolled the dice. I thought they were going to punt it, to tell you the truth. I mean, I thought, well, we'll get the quarterback there and he'll just back up and send it down. Instead, they went for it. Pankey was stopped. The defense came up. And then you get the Peppers touchdown, and we got a new ball game. Game on here on senior night. Braxton and Douglas inside the five. Will they kick it to them? Yes, they're going to. Well, they're going to kick it over their heads. So Shepard showing a strong leg there. And now if you're Oak Park, things were looking very comfortable, and now not so much.
Yeah. Well, they just have to get back to the basics, get back to what they were doing and how successful they were in that first half. A couple of negative plays on that opening drive, Kevin. So they just got to clean things up. Very clean in the first half. No penalties for the Northmen. I'm sure that's the message that Coach Clemens has relayed to him.
First and 10 from the 20-yard line. Pankey in the backfield. Pankey in trouble and fights his way close to the original line of scrimmage. But there was a lot of Indians in the backfield, and he was spinning away and doing what he can to get back to a second down and 10.
Yeah, that's how you thwart a rushing attack. Get to the ball carrier before he gets a full head of steam. And it looks like Levi Walker, the junior nose tackle.
Yeah, we got a player shaking up, but Nathaniel Parker had the
nickel safety, I'm sorry.
The penetrating play, the sophomore was in the backfield first. There's Parker there, but also back there was Isaac Fields, a junior linebacker, so they had a lot of penetration. The player being checked out is Levi Walker, who's a rover.
That's here for number one, Levi Walker.
Kind of a hybrid player,
yeah.
DB slash linebacker.
Looked like the hip of the ball carrier kind of got him on the side of the helmet. Good to see him walk off on his own accord.
Second down and 10 after the injury timeout. And play action, Hinkle throwing on the run, wide and incomplete. Good coverage there in the secondary for Fort Osage, as that was Landon Lamb. Coming back after an ankle injury, they listed about 85-90%, but this pass a little wide and incomplete.
Yep. Zone coverage. He's able to recognize the route, jump the route, actually ran a better route there. Fortunate for the Northmen, that wasn't intercepted.
And now you're behind the sticks if you're Oak Park. Momentum has shifted to the visitors. Trying to get a third down stop. Hinkle rolling, throwing, and it's complete, but looks like it's a yard shy of the first down. Third catch of the night for Clemens, the tight end, the coach's son. And just like we saw before, it's going to be fourth down and one. Do you punt or do you go for it? Last time they went for it and were stopped. Fort Osage converted a River Peppers touchdown.
Same place on the field, 29-yard line.
Nobody back to return the punt. Hinkle, once again, is the quarterback slash punter. Oh. play clock down and just take the five-yard penalty or take the timeout. No, they took the timeout. And fourth down and one after an Oak Park timeout.
It looked like there was some frustration there by Hinkle. He wanted to get a play in before the play clock went down, but it's a good, smart timeout. Make sure everybody's on the same page. You're going back to the well a second time in two consecutive possessions where you are fourth and one at the same part of the field. Don't want to make the same mistakes. Make sure all 11 guys are on the same page. Look in their eyes, check their attitudes, because it's all about, it's not necessarily about play draw, you know, how you're drawing up a play here, Kevin. It's about the attitude to get 1 yard.
Let's check in with Les.
Guys, you were right on the money on that one. Coach Clemens, you could see that Aiden Hinkle was getting a little bit nervous. He wanted to get that play in. They want to go for it. You know they want to get that first down. Coach Clemens called the timeout. Said, okay, guys, calm down. Let's talk this whole thing out. Obviously, the veteran coach knows how to handle his players, and so that was a perfectly timed timeout for Oak Park.
And this is a setup that's going for it. This is the pistol formation. And now Hinkle will take off and run, and again he stuffed. The Indians back-to-back, fourth down and one, stops. What a great job by Brock Bolt's defense as Hinkle took off. You saw space, and then you saw him hit a brick wall at the 29.
Yeah, outstanding job. What they try to do is a quarterback draw with lead blockers out in front of him, and look like Coach Clemens and his staff.
Well, now they're questioning where the spot, but it didn't look like he got to the 30 again. It looks like they're spotting at the 29.
Yeah. No gain at all. That's exactly where the ball was spotted prior to that fourth down attempt. Watch how he's going downhill. He's trying to use Pankey as a lead blocker, but there's number 47 driving his legs, making a big stop. That's Landon Sullivan, the senior defensive tackle. Makes the initial hit and drives back, showing that lower body strength to get it done.
From the 29, little pop pass. And on a jet sweep, we're gonna get the touch to Darion Patterson. No, that was Peppers. Check it. So River will line, he lines up all over the place. He lined up in a slot and came through. And he was able to get the short pickup. It'll be second down and long. Wow, 2 fourth down stops to start the third quarter, and momentum on the side of the Indians as they try to make it back-to-back conference titles in the Suburban Red. This is another running back that they insert in the game. This is Isaac Ward. We were talking about the sophomore and how his sister is an Iowa Hawkeye wrestler. Won 4 consecutive state titles.
Tough.
Yeah. I had to throw that in for Damon's purposes.
Appreciate it.
She's a national level wrestler. As they give it off to Peppers, he's going to throw it down the field. Has Ward wide open inside the 10, down to the 5-yard line, first and goal. So they go gadget. And how? What else can River Peppers do in this game? Throwing a pass and completing it to Ward down to the 5-yard line.
Well, they set this play up on the previous play, the jet sweep, and they run a little bit of a wheel route to Isaac Ward coming out of the backfield. Perfectly thrown ball, all the attention to the deeper route. Fort Osage getting the job done.
22-yard conversion from Peppers to Ward, first and goal. Here's Peppers, cut back. Peppers into the end zone, touchdown, 4-0. River Peppers from 5 yards out. Game on here in the Northland.
Outstanding job by Fort Osage, capitalizing on the miscues. 2 consecutive miscues for the Northmen on offense. Short field, they get the touchdown. Now going for 2 to tie the game.
Line up, with a standard I formation with a fullback in front of Peppers. Wilson crouching down low under center. Give it off to the fullback, and he is blown up. Second effort. The officials say he is stopped at the one. And that was Sullivan, the fullback. They went with the up man there. Sullivan lost his helmet on the play. Two-point conversion denied. Oak Park still leading 28-26 here in the third quarter.
Let's go back to the touchdown. Excellent job at the point of attack. Here's what you see from River Peppers. Great vision, downhill running. Nice job by the offensive line, and two-point conversion, stuffing it in the middle. This is the tackling we saw from the Northmen in the first half. Multiple guys getting it done. Maybe a little bit of a premature whistle there. Looked like he continued to move forward the entire time, but to no avail.
22-yard pass by number 22. Set him up at the doorstep, and then he was able to run it in. It's his third touchdown of the night. Two rushing, one receiving, River Peppers. A speedy Fort Osage running back, but 28-26 ball game. As Oak Park has been stopped at the same spot on the field, their first two drives to start the third quarter, the 29-yard line. On fourth down plays.
Two 29-yard drives.
Yep.
Ending in touchdowns. Still down by the 2 points, but everything working well for the Indians.
Shepard using his strong leg, and says, you guys will not return these as that one gets into the end zone.
We need to get everybody up.
Not really wind aided. There's a little bit of a breeze at his back, but not really that much. And now, if you're Oak Park, you're a little shell-shocked here. You're a veteran team, but now you got to box out of the corner a little bit here as you're seeing the momentum grabbed by the visitors.
Surely they're going to want to get past the 29-yard line. Nothing good has happened for them at the 29-yard line so far in this half, so they got to get back that same mojo they had in the first half.
Motion by Braxton. Give it off to Pankey. Pankey will get a couple of yards on the play as he's tackled by Bears there.
2 yards on the play.
A lot of penetration by the Indians up front. You can see right there, forcing him to stop and restart. That initial move was number 54, Gavin Gallman. We mentioned him as one of the leaders of this team, not just the defense. Penetration the key.
Thompson also involved in the stop. Boy, he is just flying around the field. But Mike Linebacker, number 7 for the Indians. And Hinkle trying to cut it back. And he is grabbed there by Danen. Just talked about him. Gavin Gallman, one of their top offensive linemen, but does double duty on the D-line and makes a nice play there. Tackle for a loss.
Yeah, good penetration again. Look how the Indians are getting off the line of scrimmage, taking on blockers. Again, that was Isaac Fields coming up the field. Strong side linebacker. He's forcing the Northmen run game to not be as efficient as we've seen them in the first half.
You say Gallman's become more of a leader on the team. Now third down, 12. And flags fly as the ball was snapped. Ooh.
Thought it was going to be the first penalty of the game on the Northmen.
Offsides. Defense, number 35, lined up in the neutral zone. 5-yard penalty, third down.
That's Owen Robertson, the defensive end. Well, now you're third down and 7. Hinkle. Nine time spinning, and he's not going to get the first down as he's run down again.
close to the 29-yard line.
Thompson ran him down. Also there, Isaac Fields as well. It's going to be fourth down and two this time, I think.
I think they're going to go with the safe route and punt the ball away. Tough run by Hinkle there. This comes up short.
And Hinkle in punt formation sends it down the field. And the Indians are just going to let this one roll out. Inside the 45 near the 42-yard line. It's a 31-yard punt and no return. And ball back to the Indians down by two, late third quarter. Winner wins the conference. Fort Osage defending conference champions, a team that was state runners up, made it all the way to the state championship game. They've always had a lot of success here. 2018, they were second as well. They were in the state semifinals in 2021. Momentum clearly on the side of the visitors as here's Peppers. And he breaks a tackle and turns on the speed down the sidelines. Oh, man, he nearly broke it. If Fields doesn't get him to the chalk, he goes to the house.
Yeah, hard nose, tough running. Good blocking at the point of attack. You see the fullback with the lead block there, and then it's all River Peppers. So slippery out there.
19 yards and a first down for Fort Osage. Trailing at halftime, 28-13, all the points for the Indians. Ball's deflected, intercepted, coming back the other way now. And just sitting down with the interception is Mike Davis, Jr. Lost his helmet, might have injured himself too. That was kind of an awkward sit down there. Hopefully he's okay. Deflections turn into INTs, and this ball is tipped. Davis, right place.
Yep, right there, and be able to capitalize. Probably should have kept on to the sideline. Got his helmet knocked off right there.
Got sideswiped there, and ball back to the Northman. He's saying he got his face mask grabbed there, and kind of that's why he lost his helmet.
A great play, great awareness.
And now the Northmen get it back. And I'll tell you what, the Indians' defense starting to fly around. So making that play was Isaac Fields there.
Yeah, Isaac Fields, we've said his name multiple times in this game, but it's all about the penetration in the backfield. And some of these plays by the Northmen have taken so long to develop, it opens the door up for the team speed to be displayed by the Indians. These linebackers are playing downhill fast, making these plays.
Fields, he is a junior. Another guy that started on the C team, now a varsity starter, also an all-conference wrestler. Excellent in the classroom, high GPA. Pankey, the patient run. And then Pankey grabbed by Thompson. Otherwise, he gets a first down run. Boy, these linebackers are really making some big tackles to save big plays in this game.
We've seen, whether it's River Peppers or Pankey here, the patience in running, setting up the blocks, as well as potential tacklers, then showing the burst of speed and quickness to make something out of nothing.
And again, into the neutral zone for Fort Osage. And that should be a penalty via, or a first down via the penalty.
Dead ball, offsides, defense. 5-yard penalty results in a first down.
Offside, all defense. And that's good. Fort Northman, first down.
Self-inflicted wound. Another one for Fort Osage in this game.
In this quarter.
Yeah.
Alpha, alpha.
Motion by Braxton. Pankey lowers his head and shoulders. to the 35. He'll get three on the play.
Getting 3 yards on the play.
Like Pinky has that running style like Le'Veon Bell did. It's not necessarily going to be hard hitting downhill. He's going to poke and prod, but then burst through. Tough to defend as we come upon the end of the third quarter.
We got a new ball game here in the Northland. 28-26, Oak Park leads it. Indians rallying. Fourth quarter ready to commence. There's your Hy-Vee scoring by quarters. All Fort Osage, 13 points in the third quarter. We got a new ball game as Pankey on second down and 7, a good run. We'll leave it third down and short, but we've got a new ball game, Dan, and final regular season game. Winner wins the conference, so a lot on the line. District standings as well. And this fourth quarter should be very interesting.
Yeah, I'm surprised a little bit that the Northmen hadn't gone back to the air. They had success throwing the ball in the first half. We heard Coach Clemens talk about wanting to run the ball, but in some of the cavities on this defense for Fort Osage could be exposed in the passing game.
Third down and 1. Here's a pass and a one-hopper incomplete to Braxton. And now these third down and short, fourth down and short scenarios have not worked well for Oak Park in the second half.
Well, I think you run that play because you know you're going for it on fourth down. They see a run play here.
Fourth down and 1. Seen 2 fourth down stops in the third quarter by the Fort Osage defense. And again, oh my goodness.
Dead ball, offsides, defense number 54. 5-yard penalty results in a first down.
Another first down via the penalty.
Same situation they had earlier. Got to be able to hold your water. Great discipline by the Northmen there.
That was Gallman,
yep.
Defensive end. Looked like they tried to get him to jump on a hard count early.
Yep.
They kind of held their water, and then, nope, they jump. First and 10, going with the pass to Braxton. Braxton can't hang on. Vince White had pretty good coverage. Braxton got a lot of gloves on that, but couldn't hang on.
Yeah, they're trying to go after Vincent White. This is great coverage and timing on the deflection right there. Gets his eyes back on the ball. Key technique there by the defensive back. Find the ball as you locate the intended receiver. Dislodges the ball, creates second down.
So Vince White, just a young sophomore, but really improved himself. Second down and 10. Quarterback read option, Pankey. Breaks a tackle, tippy toes down the sidelines. Nice run. And they're gonna spot him out, looks like at the 17-yard line. 7-yard gain by Pankey.
Seen River Peppers and Trayvon Pankey show amazing ability to keep their balance. Oh, well, he steps right out of bounds there.
Yep. Foot went out at the 17, so it'll be third down and 3, Northmen.
We'll try to get Pankey to the wide side of the field here.
Braxton in motion. Pankey, the cutback. And Pankey is a yard short.
Oh, boy.
Fourth down and 1 coming up.
As
the Indians defense. Brock Bolt, their head coach, is their defensive coordinator. They've come up big in the second half.
I'm not sure if you go for the field goal here. If you're the Northmen, maybe kicking a field goal, forcing Fort Osage to have to score a touchdown to take the lead. Looks like they're gonna go for it.
Daniel Parker, another sophomore making plays. Now fourth down. Give it off. Pankey flies forward and has the first down. Move the chains.
Excellent effort by Trayvon Pankey here. This run is all him, getting the first down, extending this drive. The Indians have it right there. Comes up, got to keep your head up. Try to square up that hit. Don't allow him to spin and get that extra airborne yardage.
That was Xander Shepherd, the safety slash kicker. Pankey went airborne, got the first down. First and 10 from the 13-yard line. Hinkle to throw on first down. Buying all kinds of time. And now throwing to the back of the end zone. Two receivers there, incomplete. Let's see, he had Evan Cook back there. And who else was back there? Braxton back there?
Evan Braxton back there as well. This is a great job because this is an opportunity for Hinkle to throw this ball errantly to a receiver that was covered. But by buying time, you mentioned, what was it earlier? The scrambling ability of him. Throw it to the back of the end zone, only in an area where one of his guys could make a play. It went through two receivers' hands there.
That doesn't matter. We've seen those catches come up after going through several people's hands.
To Evans.
Yep. Second down, 10. Northman. Pankey to the 10. Gain of three.
Got to give credit to Coach Bolton. His adjustments at halftime, Kevin. What he's able to do against the running attack. The prowess that we saw from Trayvon Pankey and Hinkle in the first half. Totally different shift that's gone on. A lot of credit to the defensive adjustments that they've made. Key fourth down stops, third and long situations because they're not getting those chunks of yards in the running game on first and second down.
Play clock winding down. On third down and 7, Hinkle rolling, throwing into the end zone, and the ball caught, touchdown. It's the coach's son, Clemens, with the strong hands, 9 yards deep in the end zone, and it is a touchdown, Oak Park. Wow. Clemens, the tight end, fighting the defender and able to hold on.
6'4", 210 pounds, but such strong hands displayed by Drew Clemens.
Extra point. My Solario is up and good, and finally on the board in the second half is Oak Park as Hinkle able to find his tight end in the back of the end zone.
Yeah, check this out. A great job of staying friendly to the quarterback, Kevin. What I mean by that is you want to attack the ball closest to the quarterback and where it's coming from. He's able to step out in front of the defender and watch his hands hit. Using those hands, holding on to it, tucked it in right before the ball touched the turf. Outstanding play for Clemens.
And for him, that is his fifth touchdown catch of the year. It's a dozen touchdown passes for Aiden Hinkle. Yards on the reception. Hinkle to Clemens, the coach's son. Brother Ty was a quarterback here, now at Dort NAIA school. And, well, that's the last I heard. Everybody transferring around.
Yeah, right.
I gotta maybe double check that. Ty was a quarterback and a good quarterback. Little brother is a tight end. Here's Thompson again on the return, and tell you what, head of steam when he catches that ball. It's like daring people to tackle him as he has good field position out to the 48-yard line.
You better be careful kicking the ball short to Anthony Thompson. Complete athlete. Just because he plays middle linebacker does not mean that he can't make plays with the ball in his hands.
Well, now Fort Osage. I think every drive in this fourth quarter is going to be crucial.
Yeah.
As there's Peppers and Wilson jogging out for the Fort Osage offense.
This is where that missed two-point conversion comes into play, down by 9 points here.
It's big.
Yeah, huge.
Two-score game. Play action, Wilson. Wilson in trouble and sacked. And that's a nice play there by Cam Wall, the Mike linebacker, the junior, as Wilson couldn't get away this time.
Well, we've seen the linebacking core for the Northmen really work well. Cam Wall, Caden Fields, we've called those guys' names multiple times. Didn't fall for the fake, the juke.
Loss of eight on the sack. Here's Wilson throwing to the outside, low and incomplete, as Penniman couldn't scoop it off the turf. And now it's a third down and 18 facing Fort Osage.
That brings up third down for the Indians.
And the home fans here at Oak Park imploring their defense and starting to feel it a little bit on their senior night. Wilson, pressure, screen pass, Sullivan stumbling, and he is denied the first down by a long shot, as right there was Wall again with another stop, the leading tackler for the Northmen, and it's a quick three and out for Fort Osage.
And the clock continues to run here.
And now let's see. Northmen want to manage the clock. Braxton, the deep man on the punt, sent down the field by Shepard. It's a nice Indians roll inside the 30-yard line.
Now you got to call, if you're Coach Bolt, you call on your defense to try to make a play. It's not just about making a tackle here. As you mentioned, a two-possession game. Got to try to dislodge the ball from the ball carriers here. May see another heavy dose of run game.
I'm with Coach Bold. I thought that ball went out on the 28. The officials are marking it at the 30. That's why I said inside the 30-yard line. The official moved it all the way back to the 30. So, all right. Coach, I'm with you on that one. Red line 34 yards on the punt. And now, see how they want to manage the clock. Oak Park running the football and a nice gain on a first down. That's the quarterback Hinkle. And
pretty close to a first down.
Yeah, I think he got it. Yeah, first down.
Backpedaled into the first down there.
Well, last week, you saw this Oak Park team, they were down on the road at St. Joe Central, and they rallied for the one-point win against Gabe Fields in the rushing attack there for St. Joe Central. But this team hasn't had a winning season in a long time, and this would be a big win to win the conference, the number one spot. It's running play, Pankey again.
Looked like Pankey was trying to stay inbound
there.
Yeah,
I was going to say, yeah, you want to stay inbounds, keep the clock running.
That's why I think you have to make the decision. I mean, each play, you can take 35 to 40 seconds off the clock for each play. Might start trying to think about running to the wide side of the field so you can avoid getting knocked out of bounds as Pankey did there.
Pankey got a good game. He got 4 yards, second down and six. Stopped the clock by going out of bounds, and now, again, Pankey near the sideline. This time he slows down and stays in bounds. And tackle there. Got a couple more yards. It's going to be a third down. They're still going to need about 3 yards on this play, but Pankey clearly learned his lesson in the last play as he hit the brakes there as he saw that chalk on the sideline.
How about getting the ball and simultaneously stiff-arming a defender? Talk about concentration, confidence.
Third down and two from the 48. Oak Park trying to seal a conference championship. Hinkle, the pitch out. Braxton, the big play man. Braxton turning on the speed down the sidelines and runs out of bounds at the, let's see where they're spotting it, at the 20-yard line. It'll be 32 yards and a first down. Danon Hughes thinks maybe he should have taken to this house, I think. Why did he run out?
Yeah, I thought he had an opportunity. This is great effort. See Anthony Thompson as well as Xander Shepherd there, but I thought maybe just a baseball slide and staying on the field of play. Maybe the stiff arm.
Yeah, I was. Shepherd had the angle and kind of ran him out, but yeah.
Stop the clock.
Yep, stop the clock, but new set of downs from the 20-yard line as the Northmen scrimmage. Little pass to the outside. Here's Braxton, another chance at the end zone. And Braxton tackled inside the 5-yard line. May have been horse collar down and is shaken up.
Yeah.
And boy, that's why they have that rule, is that the horse collar causes guys to get bad ankle injuries, tackle from behind. You make the call here. Let's see, Dana.
Yeah, great stalk block on the outside by Clemens, and then right there.
Ugh, I hate that tackle.
Yeah. Pull down from behind. Yeah, I think that might have been a missed call by the officials there.
Well, that's Bears making it. Now Braxton is shaken up. Because when you tackle, you land on the back of the guy's legs, and hopefully his legs are okay. Yes. That'll be a 17-yard gain. It'll be first and goal now for the Northmen, but now hopefully Braxton is okay. Senior night, he's had that long touchdown catch. He's had a big game, over 100 yards receiving.
The kid doesn't have fresh legs. He's been hitting shit out of all game.
There's some grumbling there from the Oak Park coaches, maybe wanting the horse collar tackle. Pankey, patient. Pankey into the end zone. Touchdown, Oak Park. Pankey. Waited and waited, slithered in for the touchdown, 3 yards out. Four touchdown night for Pankey.
Yeah, just a lot to handle for Fort Osage in this game. Give them a lot of credit. Brought it within 2 points, had a lot of momentum in the second half. Looks like the Northmen have taken total control of this game with 5:24 left. It's 42-26.
PAT good. Here's the Pankey touchdown run. Just real patient run. And got in on the right side. Nice pulling action there by Williams. On the counter move there, the left guard clearing the way for Pankey.
K-State, offer.
42-26. Home team on senior night. Braxton there trying to walk off that last tackle still in the track area.
As you mentioned, that's where those injuries can happen. We saw a 6-play, 70 yards on that drive. This is where we talked so heavily earlier, and Les did as well, about the rushing attack for each of these teams. This is where it gets kind of dicey, because you get down by multiple points. You gotta be in a position, especially with the clock not on your side, to throw yourself back into this game. It's gonna be very tough for Fort Osage, especially with the team speed on the defensive side for the Northmen.
Culp to kick off, and they're making an adjustment here, and now Peppers is moving into one of the up slots along with Anthony Thompson. Let's see how they strategically go at this.
Kick it into the end zone.
Yeah, they try to kick it deep. This will be Penniman from the 5-yard line on the return. Oak Park, great coverage, and they make the stop. And I think that's Coates coming down, Churchill Coates.
Starting
great
defensive
safety.
Back.
Yeah. And the Oak Park faithful in their pink cancer awareness starting to feel victory, feel the conference championship. said, it's been a long time. Keith Ross had those power teams. But a long time for a winning season for Oak Park, and going undefeated in the regular season. Got to go back all the way near 2000. Long pass down the field. Penniman can't hang on near his own sideline. Penniman shaking up after the play.
He's wide open, got behind the defenders there, just maybe lost the ball in the lights. He's been very shorthanded today.
He's had a lot of big catches and runs.
This is a good time to call up Arai. Please have Arai ready after the game. Students, please call up Arai.
Well, I know the Oak Park people feel it's in the bag there. The PA announcer told the students to make sure you call your parents to come pick you up now.
Who's coming
make
to get
sure,
up?
Yeah, make sure your ride is secured as Wilson avoids a sack and throws to the sideline and finds his man there. Sullivan is not bounced out, and finally bounced out by Coates. And it's a first down catch and run by Lake Sullivan.
Good hard run here again. Each quarterback we've seen get slippery in the pocket, buy themselves some time, and then get it to your big fullback. Get a full head of steam down the sideline. Nobody wants to come up and hit that.
He's a big boy, and yeah.
Lake Sullivan.
Somebody Olay'd there earlier, and then Coach ran him out after a 30-yard catch and run to the 45-yard line. There's Wilson gonna take off. And he'll get right around the first down mark. I think he's got enough. 11 and a first down as Fort Osage in the hurry up.
11 yards to play. That's good for Fort Osage, first down.
Wilson down the sideline and too wide for Penniman, incomplete. Ball ended up on the track. Coverage by Donovan Ross.
We're seeing just soft coverage, prevent defense. Don't want to get beat over the top or force the quarterback to make the toughest throw he has to make.
Second down and 10, Indians. Wilson getting the happy feet, scrambling toward his sideline. Still buying time, and he stops on the field and throws a completion to Holloway at the 40-yard line.
All the way across the field. I'm sure these guys have been watching.
Flag down,
Patrick
though.
Mahomes. Yeah. Watching Patrick Mahomes a lot.
An eligible man downfield, offense, 5-yard penalty, second down.
That's the problem when you scramble that long. Your guys get a little impatient and creep downfield. And yeah, Wilson, yeah, he just hit the brakes. And unfortunately, his linemen were down the field there. Stop. Big guy Williams kept going. Waves off the completion, and it'll be third down, and we're gonna need about 14 yards back near the 48-yard line. Wilson's pass is caught, the receiver is pushed out. And that was Snodgrass with the catch, the junior wide receiver. It's still gonna be fourth down. They're going to still need a pretty good chunk here, about 9 yards for that short completion. Hope ran him out.
Looks like the Northmen just rushed with four men, so they're dropping 7 guys.
Fourth down. Chain Gang still says third down. Scoreboard says fourth. Pass going to be intercepted. Oh, nope. Ball came out at the end. Boy, I tell you,
That's a big-time collision by teammates there.
Davis trying to have a two-interception night, and he just spilled that ball. He held it for quite a while, but lost it at the end.
Well, he lost it because of his teammate there. Both guys going for the ball, trying to throw back across your body. He tried to look off the defensive backs, but you can see right there the collision forced the ball to get dislodged. Fortunately, neither player hurt too badly there.
Well, the chain gang on the field was correct. It is now fourth down. Scoreboard was incorrect. So this could be it for the folks for Fort Osage. Fourth down and 9 from the 43-yard line, and now whistles prior to the snap.
Looked like the clock malfunctioned. The play clock is off.
Yeah, it's dark.
Delay a game. Offense, number 15. Five-yard penalty. Fourth down.
Brock Bolt saying that the clock shut off.
Delay a game on the offense.
22. What's the quarterback to do? The both play clocks are...
Yeah. Neither of them are
completely not lit up. So, I don't know if it ran out or just went on the fritz. There you see the play clocks. They're not working. So now, fourth and 14. And now Wilson scrambling. Wilson throwing, has his man. That is, again, Snodgrass, but going to be shy of the first down, I believe, here. Ball over on downs to, well, let's see what the officials, where are they spotting? No, they're saying first down.
Oh, wow.
All right. Yeah, I thought he came up a little bit short here, but we got a tough angle here as we're broadcasting from the camera bay. Say enough for a first down. New set of downs for the Indians as, again, their quarterback is scrambling and completing the pass. And that's Holloway with the catch.
We're seeing some grit by this Fort Osage team. As
that ball looked like it was tipped before it got to him.
Yeah, almost intercepted.
Yep, and he was able to keep his concentration and still make the catch. Seen a few of those balls that get deflected and go through traffic and make the catch. Here's Wilson going to go to the end zone. It's broken up this time. Snodgrass the target. Good work there by Koch, who leads the team in interceptions.
That's a great job. You want to throw to the open field, see if you can get a mismatch one-on-one. Great body control by Koch.
Second and 10 for the Indians.
First year of varsity experience, 6 interceptions. Now in, this is game number 9, so he's had a tremendous year.
He may get another opportunity for one here before this game is over.
Wilson pressured and sacked. And
Khalil Gill.
Yep, the Rover guy, and he's a little shaken up. Tries to walk it off.
Just coming off the edge, just pushes River Peppers around. Size mismatch there, and he's able to make the play.
Now third down and 19. Indians. Wilson again, the scramble, and the high floater into the end zone. And it's broken up, incomplete. That was a 50-50 ball there. Holloway and Ross were battling, and it fell incomplete.
Yeah, it looked like Holloway had an actual opportunity to bring it in without the deflection there. Looked like he anticipated some contact that didn't really come. Again, good toughness, Fran Tarkenton style. Right there, see?
Yep, he got a lot of hands on that, and then the ball rolled right across the chest of the defender, and he could have got an interception right here. Boy, these plays tonight have been crazy. Some weird, wild stuff. Fourth down and 19. Wilson throwing pass. I'll tell you what, Danon, you were, that was Ross who nearly had the interception, also nearly flipped it into the Fort Osage bench area. Watch this ball come off him. Donovan Ross nearly got his fourth interception, and he also just nearly threw the ball into the Fort Osage bench area. And ball over on downs to Oak Park.
That will pretty much seal the deal here, even with Fort Osage with two timeouts left. Not sure if Coach Bolt will utilize those timeouts or if the Northmen will run any plays here.
Yep.
Or should just be, kneel down.
Yeah, victory formation time for the Northmen as they get the victory celebration ready to go. Pankey running to the 35-yard line, and senior night will be a success, a conference championship. I talked to a coach this week, and I said, oh, yeah, these conference crowns, they aren't any big deal to the teams. And coach said, no, you're wrong, Kevin. They are a big deal. And this is what you hate to see. You got Pankey in the game getting injured late in the game.
Yeah.
This is your star player. You give him a run that really doesn't count for anything. And he may have tweaked something there. I don't know. He's holding, he was grabbing his groin, the side of his leg there. But this is what you don't want.
Yeah.
This is the kind of stuff that happens only to my fantasy football team. Kyren Williams of the Rams. He's having a 150-yard game. Fourth quarter gets hurt. Now I can't play him for a month. Well,
hey, you just got to be careful here. Team going 9-0. Make sure you're fully in full strength for the districts coming up. How about Coach Clemens right there?
Yeah.
What he's done with this program.
Coming back home, a place where he went to high school and was a star in the mid-80s. Well, Pankey must be okay because he's in the ball game. Flags down.
Dead ball, offsides. Defense number 35, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Well, that I think will be addressed by the Fort Osage coaching staff because they added some crucial defensive encroachment penalties.
Yeah.
That.
Yeah, think about how many penalties they've had that were the 5-yard penalties of illegal procedure, legal motion, false starts, and encroachment on defense.
Again, good to see Pankey, who sits down inbounds. Okay, I've been told by Patrick Morrissey, our stat guy, 10 of the penalties, 5 yards.
Yeah.
So let's, yeah, that's something that needs to be addressed when they're looking at film Saturday. And Fort Osage burning their final timeout. Well, next week is we start the playoffs, and the official announcement from the brass at Spectrum News is it'll be a Kansas first-round playoff game. We'll determine the matchups and let you know there on the X or Twitter and find out. But it'll be a Kansas first-round playoff game next Friday, the 27th of October. But the team's TBD, to be determined. I was told this would be a quick game tonight. The coaches lied to me.
Well, we thought there was going to be a
run, clock run. Yeah, okay. Well, that's when the coaches tell me that in the meetings, oh, this will be a fast game. You'll be out of there early, 9:15.
Well, Les is already upset with me.
Yeah,
I mentioned that in the open, and he looked at me with that stare.
Yeah.
I jinxed everything.
Yeah. Well, no, the coaches jinxed it like on Monday or Tuesday by saying, oh, this will be a quick one tonight. This will go real fast. We're going to be here after 10 o'clock probably.
It was a good football game, though. They're in victory formation now. Two hard-nosed teams. A lot on the line. But it was a good good football game, good high school football game, big plays across the board in the passing game and rushing. Two well-coached teams battling it out.
And now the Oak Park faithful celebrating the win as they go into the victory formation. No more timeouts for Fort Osage. Conference champions for 2023. The Oak Park Northmen will complete the regular season at 9-0. Congratulations to Ken Clemens and the Northmen staff as they complete the regular season undefeated and number one in their Class 6 district. And Fort Osage will finish the regular season at 5-4 and 3-1 in conference play, 4-0. The Oak Park conference record, Ken Clemens and Coach Brock Bolt. Showing good sportsmanship. And you know that that meme, the two Spider-Mans pointing at each other. That's that GIF right there. Those two guys very similar, but one's covered in Gatorade, and that's Ken Clemens as they get the victory tonight. The final score is 42-26. Oak Park winners, number one in their district, and number one in the Suburban Red Conference this year. What a season for the Northmen.
Yeah, great game, great season, great momentum for the Northmen to carry into districts.
And again, we want to thank Danon Hughes and Les Norman subbing in tonight. And let's check in with Les.
All right, guys, I'm with Trayvon Pankey. 27 rushes, 149 yards, 4 touchdowns. Just another day at the office for you.
Yeah, it was more of a revenge game from last year. Last year they beat us twice, took away our conference championship and district championship, and I just wanted to come out and make a statement again.
Well, one thing, it seemed like the defense for Fort Osage was coming in. They were keying off of you. Sometimes they stuffed you early, but you did a good job waiting on things to develop. You'd cut a certain way, follow your blocks well. I mean, it was just an exceptional performance. Great athleticism today.
Thank you. It's been something I've been working on for this year. Last year, my main focus was on speed and using my power to get through people. This year has been to try and get around people as well as still using the same things that I worked on last year.
Talk about your offensive line. Your coach said coming in that they've done a great job this year, and you've had a great season rushing. It's going to continue now into the playoffs. But tell me a little bit about what you feel about the offensive line and the job they've done.
Our offensive line has really stepped up this year, more so than in previous years. We have people who came up necessarily at the start of the season or afterwards, and I think they've all just really set the tone, showed what it really means to be a lineman.
9-0, conference champs on senior night. How's that feel?
It feels great. I love to come out here and do this for my seniors. Being a junior myself, I know how this must feel for them because next year's my last.
Well, thanks a lot. We'll celebrate with your team. Great job. Trayvon Pankey, player of the game. Nice work. All right, we'll send it back to you guys.
Well, Coach Clemens still soaked in Gatorade, and it was a hard-fought conference game here, and I give Fort Osage some credit. They battled back, but in the end, it was Oak Park too strong. 42-26, Hy-Vee postgame coming up right after this. A conference title to Oak Park in 2023, 42-26 over rival Fort Osage in a revenge game that the young man Pankey said, Danon, it wasn't easy. It was down to 28-26 the end of three, but two scores in the fourth quarter, the Clemens catch and then the Pankey touchdown run, and the Northmen prevail and get the conference crown.
Yeah, Northmen were the better team this evening. As you mentioned, they had a lot on the line. The revenge can be huge. Fort Osage came back and fought. Multiple fourth down stops opened the door up for them to get as close as 2 points. But when all things settled, Oak Park showed their prowess and was able to pull away late to get the big victory.
Special thanks to our school ADs, Ryan Schartz of Fort Osage, Chad Valadez of Oak Park. Thanks to the coaches, Brock Bolt and Ken Clemens. Our producer's been Tim Cornell. For Danon Hughes, Les Norman, our entire Spectrum News crew, Kevin White saying so long from Oak Park High School. Our final once again, 42-26, the Northmen conference champions of 2023 as we say goodnight from the Northland.